Hey everybody, it's Momentary Flux. Welcome back to Factorio with Yuoki Industries. In this episode, my plan is to get plastic up and running and then use that plastic to make the advanced circuits and processing units, the red and blue circuits. So the first thing I got to do is I got to get the plastic being made. So I'm going to make a few more chemical plants and we're going to just map out a little design here. I think what I want to do is I want to have the petroleum gas coming on the outside, and then the coal and the outputs will be in the middle. So I will need coal coming down here. Let me snip this before it gets too far. The coal will come down there, and then plastic will be produced and come down here and then take a left turn and go towards the red circuits. Okay. So let's make this plastic and let's add a couple more of these guys. Okay. And so we're going to have some long-handed inserters. So the coal is, we want coal coming in here, and we want plastic coming out here. And then the same goes true here, except for the opposite. We want, excuse me. So this is plastic, or this is coal coming in, and this is plastic going out. All right, that should be fine. Let's get some power poles in here. I'm going to have to put these a little further over. Excuse me. Before I power it up, let me put the pipes in. Now, right now, oil has stopped being produced because my tanks are full of the yellow and the red, the heavy and the light oil. I know they are. So I'm going to go either dump that out or do something or do something with it to get oil circulating once more. So I'm on that. There we go. So that should be everything we need. Let me hook that up to power. As soon as we get some petroleum in there and the coal, we should be good to go. All right, so that's a little excess. This is a little excess. And this will leave room if I ever need to expand plastic beyond these four chemical factories, I'll be able to. So let's just pick this up and move it over a bit. Overshot a little bit on our original attempt. Dang it. Okay, let's go down. Yeah, it's still that time of year. I'm not sure exactly where this comes up, so let's just start down here and work our way up. Yeah, that's a nice long stretch there. I didn't want to trap myself by having a belt above my production area, but I think that's going to be good. Okay, so there's plastic. I'm gonna go dump the tanks real quick. Let me see if I need to pick anything up. It looks like I need some copper, some steel. I got a ton of coal now that I need to get rid of. I got some other junk too. I got a little bit of everything, don't I? I can drop some of this stuff off. Do I have any? No, I don't have any iron ore. That in there, what the heck. Okay, we'll stock up on that, grab a little bit of steel. Suppose that the copper column would be a good spot to get rid of some of this coal, or I could have put it in the the plastic, but that's an awful lot of coal. All right, steel. Yeah, I got a bunch of wood. I don't really have anything to do with wood right now, but No big deal. I do have this giant bunker thing. Maybe I could just have this as my find a good central spot. Maybe right here, just to get rid of a few things. I have like my old gun, some injured belts I don't want to deal with, old power poles. What else? Burner miners, old drills. I can keep that ore, no big deal. And a few other things, like these are, you know, like these copper cables and gears and stuff will be consumed when I craft things. But I do have these, the iron axes, my old steel axe. I think that's about all I really want to get rid of right now. Yeah, we'll just leave that there for the time being. Oh gosh, I went over there to drain the refinery and I ran all the way back. That's okay. I need to get some more of this, some more materials anyway. I've got plenty of the green stuff. I just need some more of the blue stuff and I overran. How am I doing? I've got the pellets. Let's drop off a stack of those guys into here. I didn't mean to drop that whole stack, did I? I meant to drop the 80, not the 600. There we go. So I just want to grab a couple. I want to grab a stack of these. I think I should make more of those. Okay. Grab some Unicomp. These come in big stacks, so I can just grab it all. I have to keep an eye on that mining patch up above, too. There's going to be a lot of Unicomp coming out of there. Eventually. Looks like we got a dead mining drill here. So this is a primary miner, and I wanted to mine up this iron here first. But I do need to extend this down, so I can do that real quick. I wanted to clear out this little patch here. It looks like this one is done, this one is done, this one is done. Okay, cool. Excellent. That's almost exactly what I was hoping for. So let's get this started down here. Are those lined up? Yeah, they are. I just need to power up the right-hand side here. And I can't forget why I'm here. All right, there we go. So this gap is covered by the two miners. We'll get this, so we're good. all I wanted to do there was I wanted to clear out this little iron patch so that there would be room for a little more belt mumbo jumbo. So we're good. So let's head over to the refinery area, finally. Very good. Sip of coffee, and maybe help me out here. And while I'm drinking that, yeah, we got quite a lot of landfill. I'm gonna need some of that. How are we doing here? I'll give it a couple more stacks. So this is why the petroleum gas has stopped being made. It looks like we're full up on lubricant. We're full up on red and yellow. Unfortunately, I don't. Actually, this isn't full, is it? But I don't have cracking yet, so there's not a whole lot I can do. I suppose one thing I could do is I could run it into a steam engine. So let's make a steam engine. So I mean if you're not, I think most people who are watching this are probably aware that if you pump oil into a steam engine, I clicked that right as I auto saved. I think I'll go here. If you pump oil into a steam engine, it will consume it. It will destroy it. Let's just do it like this. This is going to be just until we get cracking in place. So, do I have any more undergrounds? Looks like I'm down to one, an odd number. Let me just pocket craft a couple of those guys. And hopefully, if I can remember, I'll grab some more on the way. I don't have enough space there, so... let's just do this. And we just need to power this up. Actually, I don't even know if you need to power it, to be honest. Interesting. Okay, so I wasn't sure that it was actually doing anything, but it is. The oil is flowing in there. It's just staying full because there's so much of it. So what's going to happen is it's going to drain out all of the red, because red is sort of getting priority in the pipe, and as soon as the red is drained out, the yellow will probably slosh in there and do that. But you can see that all the refineries are firing now, so they're producing petroleum gas is what we really want. I don't really mind that we're destroying some resources here. I really don't need all that stuff anyway yet. I mean, of course, it's nice to have it on hand, and it'll be good to convert it to petroleum gas, but it's not really hurting anything to get rid of a little bit of it. I don't need to keep adding more and more tanks. It just complicates issues, it just makes it messier. It doesn't actually complicate it, it just makes it messier. So anyway, we should be making plastic if everything is set up correctly. And it's going to be making more sulfuric acid now too. And look, there we go, plastic. Okay, so the next thing to do is I'm going to need a vast amount of assemblers. I don't have an assembler, so I'm just going to make a bunch of these. Keep an eye on those green circuit cards, which will, since I have those in my inventory, I'll be able to make them pretty quickly. And I used up all that iron. Wow. Take another drink of coffee here. I'm sounding a little croaky. Looking over technology here, what we might want to do. I think explosives is a good thing to do because it unlocks a lot of stuff, in particular alien science, which we might want once we get robotics, that you're going to need that after like the second or third upgrade for speed and for carrying capacity and whatnot. So, okay, so I'm making a bunch of assemblers. I can get started while those are being made. I've got a bunch of inserters already. So let's start here with a couple of lines. And I'll probably just do the first couple and then I'll blueprint. Okay, so I have a couple of lines, and I do a bit of a modular design where I'm not going to rely on this line of green circuits to feed my red circuits and blue circuits. I like to have them producing their own. I used to do it where I made that five assembler array that makes green circuit cards. That's very common. However, in my experience, I found that it's easier if you just feed the stuff the components that it needs directly, which are, let me pull this up here, which are so copper for the green circuits, themselves. And then the red circuits need both copper cable, plastic, and green circuits. So we got green circuits and copper cable there. So we got something like this, and then we're going to need an output for the red circuits. And the red circuits also need plastic. So we'll have plastic coming in here. I think we'll plastic comes in here. And plastic also needs to go on for the blue circuits. So we'll just have that extended on down. Okay, let's do rocketry. Okay, so there's that. I just need to pull stuff off. So let's see here. One of these is iron, one of them is copper. I think it's makes more sense to have the iron on the outside because it's less consumed than the copper. So we have copper coming in here. And I think that's it. I mean, I'll be able to sort of repeat this pattern. Like this. I'm going to make two of them so that I can blueprint the proper spot here. There we go. So let's finish this up, and then we'll have our output of the red circuits. And those will come down. And I'm out of belts? Okay, let me grab some more belts and stuff here real quick. I need some more pipes too, so I might as well just grab all that junk. How am I doing on splitters and everything? Let's stack everything up. So I got 50 of those, so I'm good there. I'm pretty good on those. I might need some more long. I'm gonna grab an extra stack of these guys, and a stack of these too, because they're gonna be used up. And of course, belts. And how am I doing on all the other stuff? Did I use all my termite bots? I still got quite a lot, but let me grab more. More. Yeah, those are the green circuit arrays. This is what I'm talking about. Like, I used to do it where I would start out with two of these circuit arrays back to back that would create the green circuit cards, and they would feed into a central line, and then the green cards would go on and feed everything that needed the green cards, and then you could also always expand that up to maybe like four of these sets. And then you can upgrade the assemblers to the gold assemblers, and you can use stack inserters, and you can really kind of speed things up there. And you can get a really fast throughput. But what I found was that a lot of times you would be short on one resource or another. Either the iron would be short, the copper would be short, and then because of the nature of the green cards being pulled out by various things. It just would sort of oscillate back and forth, and I didn't really like that very much. So when I discovered this design that I'm working on now, I just thought I would do that, because it's a very independent design. It doesn't require those green circuit networks to be working right. I still like to make the green circuits here to go to feed the various things, you know, that you're actually producing things. But as far as red circuit goes, I kind of like this design more. I don't know. Like, I'd be curious to hear what you guys have to say about it. I mean, I know it's sort of it's not abnormal, but it's definitely not something that I see in a lot of videos. Other than that one videos that I saw where the guy, he does this for his speed runs. Anyway, I kind of liked it. Let me see if I can figure out a solid way to do those power poles that are a bit symmetrical. I wonder if I can move. I can. Hang on a second. Let me get alien tech going. Get that out of the way. I wonder if I can move this. I can move that long inserter, and we have a straight line across here. I'm just wondering if how that's going to pan out up here. I think that's going to be the symmetry that I want, because this line and this line are going to be part of the blueprint. Okay. So I'm bringing stuff in, not out. So that's going to be iron. I need one more assembler here just to... So I make my blueprint. I better put in those... thing. I think if I cut it off there, that's what I need. Okay. Talking to myself here, I'm not really explaining what I'm talking about. What I'm talking about is this. I want to blueprint this, but I want to start it at the power poles. Not quite there yet. Hang on a sec. I need to add a couple of these so that those are in the blueprint. Because I'll be reusing this blueprint and extending things up there as time goes on. Like the when I need more red cards, I'll just come stamp out another batch of these things. So I know that this one's going to work because of this. This is going to work because of that too. So this, however, this isn't going to get green cards. So I'm going to have to. It's going to be dependent on the one below. So let's change this to red cards here. And let's give it a shot. Let's see if I've thought this through correctly. So I need to line up these power poles. Like so. And I think that's enough to test it. Let's get the nanobots on the job here. Let's see what we're missing. Okay, let's connect power to this whole business and see what's what. Okay, so here comes the plastic. Let's get the iron and whatnot line going up there. So the iron is on the right side, and the copper is on the left side. I wonder if I should just move that over a little bit. Just to get the belt through here. Yeah, that looks good. It's gonna take one little S here. All right, so where was the line? I think it was right there. Okay. And just for symmetry's sake, we'll put one there. I also need to put a box down here, so that'll hopefully, yeah, that should be far enough to power that up. Okay. There we go. Let's back that off one. Let's grab a steel box. That's iron. That's one thing I need to get rid of. Those iron chests. And we'll put a box here. Insert. Got a first red card. Just making sure everything's working here. So what's missing? Okay, it looks like I didn't get the this inserter into my blueprint. Okay, so let's clear that out and let's just do one more. Okay, it's in there now. I'm not sure why it wasn't before, but it's in there now. Okay. So it looks like red cards are coming out. And I can extend this up. You know, there's I don't really have a problem with throughput on the belts because it's not eating the stuff fast enough for it to really matter. It would be nice to have more plastic. That's just a matter of going back down there and killing off some more of that red oil, probably. And also, once batteries fill up this box, it looks like they have filled up this box, then and then these tanks fill up with sulfuric acid, then all of that petroleum gas is gonna flow through. I wonder why this one's not filling up. I think it's just further down the chain, basically, on the petroleum gas. I think it's all going into this one right now. Yeah. There aren't really splitters like there are for belts, for liquids. I'm sure someone knows how to do that, but anyway, okay. So that's that. And basically the blue cards are gonna be the same design, but the red cards are gonna feed into the blue cards, and we also have to get sulfuric acid piped over. Which I think I can just run over, down, and over. Anyhow, that's going to be it for this episode. And don't worry, like all those comments and stuff that people made about coal production and designs for things, I will be getting to that. But I just need to finish this up. So I'm going to go ahead and end this one here. And we will see you next time. Thanks, everybody.